Welcome to Willow Community Center. We can call this QLCC. So today I have a chance to visit Willow Competency Center. So let's look around to see what we have. Yep. So first thing we have, this is the air handling unit door. The second thing, we have a control panel of air handling unit. This is the humidity pipe. The next one, we have the spanning, the AHQ control panel, but this is the condensation part. The next one, we will have the standard part. And then this one will be the cooler system and utility system. This thing will based on two platforms. The first is the micro 800 and then second is the compact logic. Next one we will have this is the fuel device. This is the sensor for the AHQ and also the green room. We will have a pressure sensor, we have a humidity sensor and different pressure. We have a power meter in here. The next one we will have QDMS and EMS system. QDMS stands for qualified building management system, and then we have EMS, environment monitoring system. We will have a last panel. We will see the demonstration of the machine in the pharmaceutical plant. And you know that the in the pharmaceutical plant we have a lot of machine like blister, we have a fluid bed dryer, we have a mixer, a lot of machines. So this we have one with demonstration of that machine. And then in the center of the room we will have the SCADA system. This will control and monitoring everything in the pharmaceutical plant. So this is the let you know the overview of all this capacity center of Willow. Okay, and now I will bring you to discover this panel. Here you can see here this is the door of the HQ, air handling unit. This is they apply the guard door lock to protect the human go inside the HQ. If we want to go inside the HQ, we need to press unlock. The safety controller will control the safety connector to isolate the power to the motor. That makes the motor stop and protect the human go to inside the HQ. Of course, in the real one, the door will bigger a lot, not a lot of people go inside, but in here, the demo version is just a small one. So again, we drag a lot and then we open the door. The control center should see the alarm of the door open. Now, when I close the door, I finish the thing, I close the door, I reset, and then the safety motor will close the power go to the motor to normalize the HQ again. Okay, the next one we can see in here. This is the control panel of the air handling unit, but the speed humidity here. You can see in here this is the valve that control the heating coil, and then here is the cooling coil. This will these two valves will control the temperature of the air inside the HQ. In here, we also have a two drive to control the supply air fan. We also have this one, the exotic air fan. In here, we can simply, this is the HMI of the ASU. We can, let's say we can start. So this panel is based on the macro 800 platform. The next one we can see in here, this is also the same control panel, but the difference is they are control the humidity by condensation. In here we get spark. This is should be the same, and then another also the standard. You can see here the equipment that we are using is this is hot flexible. This can be the micro controller, this can be the power flat 5 to 5 or power flat 4M. we can see in here what is the difference between 3A, 3A HU type. The standard thing, normally they will control the humidity only around 70%. The condensator, this will allow of the humidity can low down to 45. And then if we want to lower the humidity control, we want the humidity is lower, we need to go to the humidity type. So this is what is the difference between three types. The next one I want to introduce, this one is the chiller and utility system. So this one is actually based on two platforms. The first is the micro 800 and mini 800. The second thing is the second platform is compact logic and battery plus 7. So this is the device, the field device that's portable. This is the device of power 505 that controls the chiller water pump. We have the same that controls the chiller. We have a cooling tower of air, and then we have a cooling tower water pump. Right now, the platform Micro 800 control this one. We can start from here. So right now, the Micro 800 will control all the heat. So this is what we have if we're using the PV 800 and Micro 800 for the chiller and utility system. We will have this HMI, this one will control the pump. Let's say for example, if the customer wants to change to the compact logic platform. Okay, right now I just try to stop this one from Micro 800. Right now I will change. Wait. I will change the mode to the compact logic. So I will try to control from here. So this is the HMI that we apply for it. Okay, right now the compact logic control the device is below. So if we are using the compact logic platform and then QLCC 7, we will have the process library or playback library in here. We apply this one while if we are using the Micro 800 and PV 800, we don't have enough concern. When we apply the system with the compact logic and playback plus 7, we will be using the playback library. So the playback library, we have a lot of advantages that of the diagnostic. We have a advantage of the interlock. So whatever, if they have any interlock, they will display here what is the interlock, and then we can go to inside and then see this. Later on, I will show you in this camera system. We have in here, that's all this one, we apply for the ADC function. So when we change the drive, the configuration will download automatically from the VOC to the new drive. That's it. Don't need to do any configuration if we are changing the new drive. Okay, the next one, I would like to introduce this one is the field device. The field device is normally in the ASU and then the clean room. We will have three types of device of the sensor. The first is the air pressure. The second is the humidity. The third is the temperature. We have here the barometer to measure the energy and then the current voltage of the motor and the load. We have alarm. The local alarm indicator that will let the operator know the temperature, the different pressure, the humidity already go up or go out of the range. So they need to do the corrective action to maintain the environment back to the normal one. We have another panel. This is the EMS and QDMS system. This one is based on the redundancy system. That we have a two control machine here. This is the redundant CPU dust control for IO in below. In the top one, we have the demo of the filter machine. We can see in here, we can run this machine. This is the demo of the filter machine. For this one, we from this one, we can see that, for example, the origin of the machine. In here is the gain 5400. And then we also have the buffer 505. And the last one is the demonstration of the machine that can be connected to the another frame controller. So the SMI here can connect to another controller, and then also another controller can connect to the scanner system also. This is let you know all the panel function. So now we can go to the function of the scanner system to let you know that what we can do from the control center.
And now I would like to introduce the functional detail for the scanner system. The first thing, we will go with the HQ dust control based on the logic platform. The logic platform can be the control logic or compact logic. We can see the view in here. This is apply the slabbed library that we have a lot of advantage. We can go inside one, select this one. You can see we have for each object we have the operation, the operator task. We have the maintenance task. We have engineering task. We have a diagnostic task. We have a train task, and then we have a alarm task. In here, let's say for the board. We have the interlock. That interlock will let you know what is the condition to shut down the HQ. Let's say for example, now I press the E stop, and then you see what happened. I press the E stop action. Yeah, you can see in here the E stop will on. And then this will not allow you to start the HQ. So let's say for example, I will normalize this one. Reset. Okay, the stop will okay. And then this will let you start the HQ. During this one, I would like to introduce you that's the diagnostic of the AC. Here we will have a, let's say for, we will probably see the AC diagnostic. But we will have a how many hours of AC already running or in the idle state or in the stop state. How many times does they enter to the running, and then the maximum hour for each section they are going. In here we also have the status bar that will let you know how the HQ running last 24 hours. We have the MTPS, this means that mean time to failure and then mean time to repair. It's the same function. If we apply with the micro platform will have this display. This one actually the same functional of the AQ that apply the logic. But in here we don't have the lambda library. That is the advantage that we don't have a diagnostic, we don't have the interlock for diagnostic of this item inside the interlock, but the function of AQ should be the same. If we start the AQ, it's running now. Okay, we move on to QLCC system. Okay, right now the cooler system is running. The demand is fine. Let's say we lower the demand, so the system will be shut down or fill off children. We decrease to 12. Now the demand is 3. So it means that they will shut down this 2 line. The power to shut down is 1, 2. So this is depend on the priority. We can, the system can rotate the priority by automatically or manually. Next one, we will go to the EMS system. You can see in here, this is the whole layout of the pharmaceutical plant. The EMS system, what is the functional of the EMS system? EMS system will monitoring the environment inside the clean room of the pharmaceutical plant. Let's say for example, we'll go to this room. So let's say we'll go to the humidity. Right now it's 51%. The lowest allow is 20, the highest allow is 55. We simulate this value to 55. Right now you will see the alarm here. Let's say we increase to 61. So this will have the alarm. The first alarm we want, now is the alarm is out of the range. So this will alarm the operator to do the coordination to make the condition become the normal. So let's say for example we are normalizing humidity like 50%. The alarm will off. Then we try to reset. Now we are moving to report system. So this report system is based on the vantage point. The first thing is we will have the alarm story. We can select the day. And then they will look for the alarm. In this system we have two folder, the EMS and the DMS. EMS is mean that the alarm related to the environment monitoring system, and then the QDMS is mean that this related to the qualified building management system. You can see here after you see they will lead down the alarm. This also allow you to have a filter. For example, you want to see the alarm of the pressure. And then you select view. This will filter for you. The alarm only contains the work dust pressure. Yeah, you can see in here. This is the alarm related to the pressure. The next one, we can see the top 10 alarm dust last very long. We can see in here. Yeah, here you see. They will lift down for you the alarm. That's happened in really long. We can see another reporting that they will leave that for you the top 10 alarm that happen frequently. You can select the time. Yeah. We also have the top 10 alarm dust. The alarm time to acknowledge dust from the alarm happen until acknowledge until operator acknowledge this. This take a long time, so this will leak down dust, the alarm dust operator take a long time to acknowledge. So this one, this is similar with the QVMA system. So I will skip this one for this. So we will go to the audit trail report. The audit trail report will record everything related to operate the system. Like for example, we will set this value to how much, who will perform this, and then what is the time to perform this action. So they will record everything in here. This one will let the auditor to know when system have any problem, when the product have any problem. They will train the activity to let you know, to let the people know that what is going to happen. We will have an energy reporting. The energy that's more. This report will take the data from the barometer that I showed you in before. So then you have a, you see here that we have a current demand and how much, and then this is the historical. The important thing in this system is this is the reporting for the EMS and PDNS system. They will record all the parameters in here. You can see in here. This is the all the record from the temperature, the humidity and the different pressure. So they have a low and high. If the value is out of this range, this will highlight. Let's say last time we are doing a simulation that's out of the range. We can select less than like we can select 10 seconds. We are now is 24. We go to 25. And then let's see how we have. We go to the last page. Yeah, this one is the time we are doing the simulate. That's out of the range. Okay, this is similar when we go to the QVMA system. This is the parameter related to the ASU. We have all the parameter. That's how much for the set point and then the current value is how much. Yeah, this is the temperature, the humidity, and flow. So we have the set point, and then also we have the actual value. All this reporting you can export to the PDF file. Yeah, they will download there, and then you can open the folder. And then you see here, this is the reporting. Then you can print out or you can submit to any people, any related people or far people to validate system. Okay, so we move next to alarm. This alarm will let you know what is the current alarm that happened right now. And then we also have the historical alarm if you want to see in here, or you can go to the report and then, see from the report. We have a frame. This is the custom frame. We can select any data you want to see. This see ever a loss that does whatever you think you want to see, and then you just select. Then they let you know what you want to see. Or you can see the display frame. You already prepare all the frames related to the EMS and the DMS system. So you just click in here and then you will see what is the high limit, the low limit, and then the actual value. So you just click in here and then you see the detail. Or you want to see the custom frame, and then you can go to here and then just select any tech that you want to see. The last one I want to show you is this is the connected to the machine one. Let's say for example the machine last time we are seeing this is the printer machine. Right now if the machine is running, this is the speed is 50, we can change the speed or even we can stop the machine. You can see in here that's it, we have the smart machine template in here that will let you know. This is how the machine run last 6 hours, how the machine how many hours machine stop it, how many hours machine aborted or running. We can see the OE of the machine in here also. In here we can see what is the frequent alarm warning or general event that's happened in the machine. We can see the mean time to ferro and mean time to repair of the machine. Next one we can see, this is the fabric dust connected to the another frame QLC, so our system can connect to the another frame to monitoring and control. So this is full overview that I would like to introduce to the wheeler. Hopefully that you have the overview of this wheeler compensation center. Okay.